What's going on? In this video, we will install Kali 2019.3 in VirtualBox 6.0.14. This is where you download VirtualBox. The latest version as of today is 6.0.14. The process should remain the same even if this version changes. I'll put the link to this download for VirtualBox beneath the video. Kali Linux, we're using the version for VirtualBox. This is where you download that. It is 2019.3. I'll put the link for this as well, but they've already been pre-downloaded and I've already installed VirtualBox. This is the Kali file I downloaded. It's roughly 3.4-ish gig, so it may take a little bit of time to download. It is a OVA file. In VirtualBox, it will mention something about only working with OVF files. That's okay, it will still work with an OVA file. Once you've downloaded and installed VirtualBox, we'll go to Oracle VirtualBox Manager, go to File, Import Appliance. This is where we're going to import that OVA file we downloaded. Click on the little folder here, browse to that file, which is I put on the C drive under Kali. There it is. Click on Next. I like to rename this, so there's a couple options you can change right here. You can always change them later if you want to. I like to go ahead and make the changes here though. I'm gonna call this Kali 2019.3. This is the name of it that shows up in VirtualBox Manager. So like over here on the left, this will show up as one of the virtual machines, but it will be named Kali 2019.3. I'm also gonna change the number of CPUs to 4. I like to have my virtual machine run a little bit faster and change the RAM to 4096. So I'm gonna give it 4 gig of RAM. This particular laptop has 16 gig of RAM. So that's good enough. The other thing you may want to change is the directory where it stores the appliance files, the virtual disk file, the configuration files, all of that stuff after it imports the appliance. So just to be clear, that OVA file is just like a source file, kind of like an ISO, but the actual files that make up your virtual machine will be in a different directory. In this case, I am putting them under DVMs. Click on Import. This will take a little while to import because we're importing that 3.5 gig file. We're importing that into VirtualBox and we're making a separate virtual drive image file and a separate configuration file. It may take a little while to import. I've paused the video for a while. Mine is taking roughly 4 minutes. We have a few seconds left here. It's finally finished importing. So it's over here on the left, Kali 2019.3. That's what I named it. Now let's go ahead and power it on. You can just click on Start up here in Oracle VM VirtualBox Manager. Go ahead and hit enter here, or you can just wait, it'll eventually start up. And I saved mine in the DVMs folder. I'll show you what this actually puts in that folder. Because remember, we imported the .ova file, and it creates some different files in the VM folder or wherever, whatever folder you choose to save it in. So for me, on the VM folder, I have Kali 2019.3. We have a VDI file, which is a virtual disk image file. This is the file that acts like the hard drive for Kali. And we have the virtual machine setup or configuration file. Go ahead and close that. If you get this screen, that's fine. It'll take a little while for the logon prompt to show up. The logon by default for Kali Linux is root. And then the password is Tor. So R-O-T and T-O-R, which is root spelled backwards. Those are the default credentials. I highly recommend you change those credentials after you log on. So there's really two things we wanna do to verify this is working. We wanna see if we can ping the internet. Right now, we didn't change the network settings, so we should be NATed through our host. If we go up here to machine settings, we should see under network NAT. So we're being NATed through our physical host, which is how it's set up by default, and you can change that later. So let's go ahead and verify we have connectivity. So I'm going to ping alpinesecurity.com, and we're getting response back, so that's working. So this has connectivity. As I mentioned, we want to change the password and do an update. So I'll go ahead and do those real quick, and then we'll end the video. So to change the password, I'm going to make this larger. You can press Control Shift and plus. You can just hit passwd, enter, and then put a new password, and then confirm the new password. So I changed the password. Now we're going to do apt-get update. This will update the repository on Kali, so it will tell Kali all the newest packages available. We're not actually upgrading anything. We're just updating what new versions of the install packages are available. And then the next step after we've done this is to do an apt-get upgrade. So apt-get upgrade, and this, upgrade. And this will tell you what it's going to upgrade and how much space it will take. I'll go ahead and click yes here. So this will upgrade Kali to the latest version, and all the packages on Kali, I'm sorry, to the latest version. So that's basically it. We've installed Kali 2019.3 in VirtualBox. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them beneath the video. Also, please like the video and subscribe to our channel so you can get notified when we have more cool and exciting videos come out. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later.